Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Students, I am Dr. Khawar Batul. And what will be the practical that we will be learning today? It is demonstration of direct and indirect light reflexes. Now, all of you should learn at the end of this practical that what is direct light reflex, what is indirect light reflex, what is the reflex arc, and what is the procedure of these reflexes to perform. So what would be the protocol to perform this practical? Obviously this protocol is same for each and every practical, and you will have to perform these three steps for each practical in which you are having a subject. You are assigned specific marks for these subjects, for these steps to perform. First of all, introduce yourself to the subject, then take consent, and afterwards explain the procedure before starting the practical. Now let us move to what is light reflex. So whenever light is thrown into eye of a person, there is reflex constriction of both the pupils. This reflex constriction of the pupils is called as light reflex. So that is the reason we also call this reflex as pupillary reflex. So what are the two types of this light reflex? One is direct light reflex and the other is indirect light reflex, or which is also called as consensual light reflex. Both these are the name for same reflex. Now how will you explain that what is direct light reflex? On throwing the light into the eye, the constriction of pupil of same side is called direct light reflex. Whereas when we will study the constriction of pupil on the opposite side, it is called as indirect light reflex. Now after explaining, let us proceed to what is the principle behind this reflex. Basically, the optic nerve, which is second cranial nerve, it carries special sensation of vision. Some fibers reach the pretractal area, which is present in the midbrain, and it controls the pupillary reflexes. Some of the fibers cross, and due to this crossing over, some fibers at the pretractal area, indirect light reflex occurs. Now let us see in a flow chart that how these reflexes are elicited. First of all, see, when a stimulus is thrown in the form of light onto the retina, it is perceived by special receptors, which are photoreceptors. This stimulus is carried to the pretractal nucleus of midbrain via second cranial nerve or optic nerve. This nerve is called efferent nerve. At the pretractal nucleus, the fibers cross over. The efferent fibers from pretractal nucleus reach the ciliary sphincter via lower motor neurons. The fibers, efferent fibers to the ciliary sphincters, are carried by third cranial nerve. Both these fibers are called efferents. So you can see that for the direct light reflex, the reflex pathway followed would be from this retina to the pretractal nucleus and ciliary sphincter of the same eye. Whereas for the indirect consensual reflex, light travels from to the retina, then to the pretractal nucleus, and then to the ciliary sphincters of the opposite eye. Now, after this procedure, after this explanation of principle, let us move to how you will perform the practical. If you have any confusion, you can ask in the comment section. Now, what is the apparatus that we will need for the practical? It is a torch and a comfortable stool. Proceeding to the procedure, first three steps that I have already told you in the form of introduction, consent, and explanation of the procedures are must. After this, to perform the direct light reflex, you will ask the subject to sit comfortably on the stool. Then you will ask him to focus at some distant object. Why are we performing this step? So that a direct light reflex should not be confused with the accommodation reflex, and the accommodation reflex for any nearby object is omitted. In the third step, ask the subject to cover his opposite eye, or if we are performing on the right eye, ask him to cover the left eye. Then bring the torch from the side of right eye. Never bring the torch from the front. And then record your observation in the same eye. Same steps would be followed for the left eye. Now, what is the procedure for indirect light reflex? To look for the light reflex in the right eye, you will ask the subject to place his hand between the two eyes so that light should not cross over. Then throw the light from the side of right eye and record your observation in the opposite eye, that is left eye in this case. Similarly, you will perform indirect light reflex on the left eye. Students, always remember here that you have to perform both of these reflexes in both eyes. You cannot omit any of the eye. Now there is a question that arises, that why these reflexes are important. Basically, the diameter of pupil changes between 8 to 2 mm during light reflexes or pupillary reflexes. Due to this reflexes, the damage to the retina is prevented in the bright light. It also enhances depth of the focus. Moreover, these reflexes also decrease spherical and chromatic aberrations. Now, students, let us perform a practical. Assalamu alaikum. जी, मेरा नाम डॉक्टर खावर बतूल है और आज हम आपके ऊपर आंखों का मुआयने का टेस्ट करेंगे. इसके लिए हम आपकी आंख की एक तरफ से लाइट लाएंगे और उसके अंदर देखेंगे लाइट से. क्या आप इसकी इजाज़त देते हैं?
जी.
फॉर द प्रैक्टिकल टू बी परफॉर्म, वी विल डिम आवर लाइट्स. अब अपना बायां हाथ बायां आंख पर रख लें. फॉर द डायरेक्ट आई रिफ्लेक्स, वी विल ऑब्जर्व राइट आई फर्स्ट. You can see constriction of pupil. अब बायां हाथ दायां हाथ रख लें. बायां आंख छोड़ दें. बिल्कुल दीवार की तरफ देखेंगे. You can see अब आमिर साहब अपना हाथ अपनी दोनों आंखों के दरमियान रख लें इस तरीके से कि लाइट दूसरी तरफ ना जाए. नाउ वी विल थ्रो लाइट इन टू द राइट आई एंड ऑब्जर्व फॉर द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ पीपल इन द लेफ्ट आई. कंस्ट्रक्शन इज प्रेजेंट. नाउ फॉर द अदर आई, we will perform indirect eye reflex by throwing light into the left eye and observing for constriction of pupil in the right eye.